Hello, Tomáš is here, bringing another video. I have two programming drills for you. Both will be about floating point numbers. The first one will be theoretical, where we will discuss how floating point numbers works, and the other one will be about examples, an implementation, some comparison, some technique to use these numbers. Yeah, the first video can be a bit boring, a bit unnerdy stuff. We will study here the standard for double precision, but in order to be able to use these numbers with confidence, I would say it feels good when you know something about them. Yeah. So let's start with the theory. Okay, so floating point numbers, as we have in C language, keyword float and keyword double. And in this video, I will focus everything on double, which is full name is double precision floating point data type. And the difference between those two is just basically double is 64 bits. And float is 32 bits. So basically, the difference is just the size of exponent and size of mantissa. And otherwise, it's just like the same story. Okay, so let's focus on double. In our representation of double, we have 1 bit for sine. When we have 1 bit for sine, it means that other thing will be just about absolute value. It works pretty symmetrical. So when I will be speaking about high numbers, I will be just speaking about high numbers with numbers with a high absolute value, and low numbers, I will be speaking about small numbers like close to the zero, not negative numbers. Yeah, because we have sine, just basically small to sine. So let's keep it on mind. Okay, so exponent is 11 bits and mantissa is 52 bits. Like technically there is a bit more, but one hidden bit. We will go through that later. Okay, and this is what I tried to explain as the simple way to understand, to be able to use this number as a programmer. When you have to actually know how these numbers are encoded, there will be some more details about that. So the simple way is that you have a sign, you have a sign, and as I defined it just like minus one or plus one, so we can might multiply that. Kind of feel weird having it without multiplication, so do it like this. Then we have mantissa. Mantissa is always normalized between 1 and 2. And 1 is possible, but 2 is not. When number is normalized, mantissa is smaller than 2. Then we have exponent. These are like the range for exponent. Exponent is like an integer. Lowest value, minus 1023, is reserved for 0. Because as you may notice, when we have mantissa, which is a number between 1 and 2, we multiply by 2 power exponent, we would never get 0, like real 0. So yeah, there is a trick that This is the special value for exponent, which means the zero. And there is also a special value of exponent, the most is the highest number of possible on exponent, which represents some special values like not a number, positive infinity or negative infinity. Yeah, so this is way to understand to be able to use it. If you want to study more deep, actually how hardware use it, because for hardware complexity, the standards has some details. Let's just quickly go through them. So sine is just a bit, so like this. You can write it like this. Then this is actually the mantic. This is actually something that it can confuse you. Here is one decimal point. This one is a hidden bit, because as we said earlier, mantic size is always between 1 and 2, and 2 is excluded. So here is always that one decimal point, and this is just a fraction part of mantissa, which is stored in that variable, in the double precision variable. Okay, so that's about the hidden bit. So let's discuss a bit some limitations. Yeah, when I did actually the study, when I did my preparation, I realized that this Wikipedia page in English is actually a nice source. So you can follow it if you want. So about the precision problems. Some numbers, of course, doesn't have much, or that couldn't be in that limited size represented precisely. So, like numbers like 1/3, it's like when you write it in positional notation, it's like 0 decimal point 3333, and it's like never ending. And something similar happens, for example, where we wouldn't even expect, like for example, 0.1 is a number which doesn't have finite representation in binary, as well as those numbers basically are screwed. We can't precisely store them. What we can precisely store are the number of the negative powers of negative powers of 2, like 1/2, 1/3, 1/8, and these numbers. How we can view the precision, I would here maybe follow another Wikipedia page. It's like we can understand it in simpler way, like between 15 and 17 significant decimal digits. So when we have some number, it'd be nice to show some example. So where we have some number like 5, 6, 7. Yeah, so let's say we have a number like this, which is 15 digits, and this one is will be okay. This is the most significant digit, this is the least significant digits. Our double can store like 15 to 17 the most significant digits. So what this here, we actually, well, this here actually double doesn't matter. Double always matters about the most significant digits, as here. Yeah, and also it doesn't much matter where is the decimal point. It can be small number, like very small number, or it can be very large number, but these 15 most significant digits is something like we could say that these will be valid, this will be good. Yeah, but about the error of let's speak about error. Let's say that error is the distance between a value we want to have and value we have in double. Yeah, because in double we can represent just some lucky numbers which are correct without any errors, but other numbers, the most of the numbers, will have some error. And I would like to continue here about losing precision. When we have some computation which requires a lot of operations with these numbers, it basically error can accumulate. Let's see how error happens. So when we have multiplication, just imagine that we have two numbers with mantissa 1 exponent 1, mantissa 2 exponent 2. Multiplication is simply multiplication of these mantissas, and it will sum the exponents. And this, I think, problem that happens usually in here. Mantissa times upper mantissa, which are 252 bits, are multiplied, and basically result have to fit in 52 bits. So least significant digits are basically dropped out. You just don't use them. And then about the plus and minus operation, numbers have to be converted in a same exponent. So mantissas are sum, then mantissas, then we can sum up deduct mantissas. So here's the example number 2 power minus 10 and 2 power 10. So firstly we have to convert both on exponent plus 10. So we have to shift the first number by 20 bits to the left side. So how we do that? We just fill this by 20 zeros, but we have to drop out least significant digits, right? And so here we are also losing precision. Then we will sum up those two numbers. And as you can notice, here it works well, but as you can notice, summing to mantissas can exceed, it can exceed 2, right? So then it has to be also normalized back between 1 and 2, and so that the exponent will be increased. And this is, so we have to, we may also drop other digit there. Yeah, so this is how precision is losing during the computation, Yeah, let's talk about numbers, which may be interesting. Let's talk about numbers which will be like nicely stored in double without any errors. So which integer screen do we have? Basically, it's a sequence of numbers from minus 2 or 53, minus 1. This is the negative 1, this is the positive 1, plus 1. And it makes sense when an exponent is 53. Yeah. The basis for Mantissa is just like an integer, so this makes sense. And almost or fits naturally, but zero has some special value reserved on exponent, so you have to really this range. Also with zero, and these integers will fit correctly in double. So it's all 32-bit integer, signed, unsigned, it will fit correctly. So let's see also some, I have here some short program. Let's open it here. So I have here some program which will show these numbers, and these couldn't fit correctly, but these are negative powers of 2, which will fit correctly. And there is one other example. This number is very high, and we call this number 1 Google. It's 1 and 100 zeros. And this number is very small, and you shouldn't be surprised that this equation holds, because this actually doesn't have any effect on the number. Imagine how those numbers are correlated to the same exponent, and what happens with this mantissa? Like, it's zeroed over all the time. So this shouldn't surprise you. So let's see the result. Yeah. So as you can see, here we have like some most significant digits results. And then there is some random trash, basically, some error. Here, if we round about here, it will be correct, it will be 0.3, but as you can see, when we show exactly the value, it will be just some kind of difference. Okay, and these numbers, these are lucky, because these are negative powers of 2, these are pretty much okay. These are correct, and also combination of these one, these numbers will be correct. For example, .5 plus this number will be correct, because it can be easily represented in double. Yeah. So this is an example. Also, here on Wikipedia page, we can see. Here are some values, and this is the representation of double. Here we have sign bit, here is exponent, here is mantissa. Yeah, so for instance, this is this one. Yeah, there is a thing that I forgot to mention. In hardware, the exponent is encoded. Okay, let's show this. In hardware, the exponent, it's basically stored like this. Exponent is like unsigned integer, but before we use it in the formula, we subtract the 1023. This is called, I think it's called additional code. It's not two complements, and it's not unsigned. It's not absolute value and signed. It's additional code, which means that if we will just shift the number by here the deduction. So if we have zero stored, it will subtract to minus 1023. So 1023 subtract by minus 1023 will be zero, and the highest number. Yeah, so it works like this. So therefore, we would expect here some other value, but we have this one, which is this one is it's 2 to the power 11 minus 1, which is 2 power 11 minus 1. Like, yeah, 2 power 11 minus 1. I don't know right now which what value it is. No, this is 2 power. Power 10 minus 1. Sorry, I'm a bit confused. Because of 11 bits isn't very very often we see. Basically we should have epsilon this is 0, so it's 1023 basically. Yeah, so it's 2 power 10 minus 1. 2 power 10 minus 1 gives us the 0 here as the exponent. Because 2 power 0 is 1, right? So it works. Yeah. So this is 1. There are some special values for. We have two zeros basically, negative 0 and positive 0. The 0 is. But the hardware knows 0 because of this special value of the exponent. This is positive infinity, negative infinity, because of the exponent, and there are some not a number. Positive and negative infinity may happen when we divide by 0. In float, it is possible, and not a number may happen when we want something illegal, like minus 1 square root from negative value or something like that. The computer couldn't compute, so it will give some special value like this. Basically, when you are having some special value in your, when you're having special value in your computation, like other computation, the results of computations using these numbers will just give you also these special values, like you have not a number, e plus one, you will get not a number, so like these we don't want to this happens, but it's just a sign that something like this happens, which is nice. Yeah, so this is one third approximately, and this is the closest value to the pi number which we can represent. Yeah, and I think we pretty much went through that, so I think we are pretty much done with this video. So let's see you in the next one. Goodbye.